And now at 5 to 5, Bristol Cathedral Organ, fresh from a major overhaul, is played and introduced by Simon Preston.
This newly restored organ was originally built by J.W. Walker and Sons in 1907. It has 4 manuals, tubular pneumatic action, and a full complement of romantic sounds, including a splendid-sounding tromba on the solo organ, as you will hear at the end of the programme. No trace of baroquery existed in the 1907 organ, and Manders have restored this instrument very much in sympathy with the original conception, including, apparently, several miles of lead tubing. The sort of music played by organists in 1907 might well have included the piece I am going to begin with, the march upon Handel's Lift Up Your Heads by Guilmant. March upon Handel's Lift Up Your Heads by Guilmant. The most famous forerunner of the present instrument here in Bristol Cathedral was, of course, the 1685 instrument by Renatus Harris, built the year Handel was born. The casework and some pipes are still preserved in the modern instrument here today. Harris's instrument had three manuals, great, echo, and choir, 18 stops, and no pedals. I'm going to play next Handel's Organ Concerto, Opus 7, No. 5 in G minor. This is one of six concertos published after Handel's death, and in which the composer's intentions are unusually clear, with very little in the way of ad libitum markings. The idea of arranging a concerto for solo organ isn't as outlandish as it might seem. After all, Walsh, Handel's publisher, arranged Handel's Opus 4 concertos for solo organ or harpsichord, and it's thought that Handel himself probably improvised these pieces at the keyboard before he began the process of turning them into concertos for orchestra and organ. Handel was, of course, the inventor of the organ concerto. This concerto in G minor has four movements, with two short linking sections between the first and the second movements, and between the second and third movements. The second movement is a set of variations on a ground bass, which lends itself well to solo arrangement. The third and fourth movements are dances, a minuet and a gavotte, neither of which had a part for solo organ originally. Handel's Organ Concerto, Opus 7, Number 5, in G minor. Of course, the glory of this particular instrument, one of only three Walkers of this period surviving in this country, is its rich, full romantic sound, providing the player with a multiplicity of colours and combinations of registers appropriate to romantic music. We pay further homage both to Handel and the world of romantic organ sound with variations on a theme of Handel by the German composer Arno Landmann. Landmann, born in 1887 in Thuringia, was a pupil of Max Reger and Karl Straube at the Leipzig Conservatory. He worked for most of his life in Mannheim, producing many organ works, but also a symphony for organ and orchestra, some songs, and an oratorio. These variations were written between 1935 and 1948, and the theme in question is the Sarabande from Handel's Harpsichord Suite No. 6 in G minor. Landmann has constructed the variations so that they are closely woven together to produce an almost symphonic tapestry. The harmonic language owes much to Reger, of course, but the structure is almost Brucknerian. As a German remarked to me after I'd played the piece recently in Lübeck, "Do you mean to say this composer lived in the 20th century?" And yet there are dashes of modernity, not unlike Hindemith, perhaps, or Hugo Dissler. Here, then, is Variations on a Theme of Handel, Opus 27, by Arno Landmann.
Thank you.
Simon Preston introduced that recital on the newly restored organ in Bristol Cathedral. The final work that he played was the set of variations on a theme by Handel by Arno Landmann.